Keats' shadow broke one day dumbly in a flash gone. Quick, mine. Black numbness, soft shoeing.
Blah!
A huge dirty dance of demons. Huge life, simian issues. Issues of a runny tongue. Running like a rogue, violently. In the clasp of lapsed reasons, rasp or quiet as don't know which. What is the end of beginning? yes, this is the end of the beginning. Keats lent me his horn for a while, so check out this frail feast. It is a small thing. This is a poem of angles, not shapes. It is a small smile for a moment, kind of slapped on the muse, beautifully full. Fleeting. Yes, I contradict myself. Do not bother to apply full-fledged meaning, yet get at it from parabolic angles. I launched the flash, and it is in my dry head drearily, and filled up is this cup of desirous man's thoughts, wine, winding thought. Think, or drink. Spit out flyers, flashing a sweat on you. Shit, why is it all so spastic, fickle, and filled to burgeoning plenty with the wine of spiteful drab meaninglessness? And the language is wildly numbed, broken by too tampering time. The shadow came and told me I was on the right track, and it was like a sting of split hope slipped into the fat of my turning mind. In big fat lights doomed throughout, and it was like amorphous passionate drifts, cloaks of weather and soft doughty herbs, reflections. Oh, this. My damp silly intrepidness in a screen of rain, dropping drops. Rain falling like ash in Vesuvius. That is an affair and shining enterprise. Big rain and like a story finished. Too. At least for now it is finished. Yeah, dizzily, the plasm direct spiked like some causeless flooring of my dumb words to the brand spanking life's broad strokes. Tragic. Verbose. Audacious. With or without substance simultaneously. Nice and simultaneous. And all in every aspect, shouting like whispers. Like dropping fucking brains on the big field of neon grain. Radioactively absurd and bungling in a chance not pursued. So then not a chance. Not one chance for me to break into, make normal, accurate. And love that is instant love of lovely things. Broad and shattering, dead, already dead. Compromised as my sleep is on most nights. Yes, and contemptible, and yet I accepted my stupid saying as being all I would be able to get built, could ever offer. He said that was enough. He said he was more than shadow. Yet as I could see askance from that there perspective, the berms of them scarily stranded corners of my brain, well, the shadow seemed not the quality of a man, but of one known to dovetail with a liquor of a point. Yes, or many. Sometimes mawkishly written. And yet he knows what he is doing. The flaws I get more. I knew him once to be on page. I knew not the floor of my own dumbed-down thoughts carnage. Only knew the carnage. I knew only the carnage. Only knew the link to be more broken than once I thought it to be. Realized the importance of acknowledging a link however long ago it clasped together the sublime. This will be flawed. Excitable. This will be a good poem, said the shadow. You will write it in my stead, in a reverie so sad and janky as to shake the nice and rotten world apart. John Keats had come to me before, whilst I was dreaming he came and was the very lattice to uphold the dignity of my broad truths. I was drowsed, drowsy, all soulful, songed in that crude step of this unbelievable heaven without my knowing it as one would know the nature of their human needs and ends. The shadow droned to me in his brave boredom, fortuitously grave.